for a 1% pay offer in England and for showing what she described as a lack of respect for health workers. The Prime Minister praised the care he'd received at St Thomas's Hospital in central London when he was discharged just over a year ago.
It's hard to find words to express my debt, and I hope they won't mind if I mention in particular two nurses who stood by my bedside for 48 hours when things could have gone either way. They're Jenny from New Zealand, Invercargill on the South Island to be exact, and Luis from Portugal near Porto.
Downing Street said the government was extremely grateful to NHS staff, and that was why they were exempt from a public sector pay freeze implemented during the pandemic. Boris Johnson's warned people against holidaying in amber-list countries after a minister said people could go and visit friends abroad. There was confusion after the Environment Secretary, George Eustace, said people could go to those countries if they quarantined when they returned. Here's our political correspondent, Ben Wright.
Ministers, including Boris Johnson today, have been at pains to say that all travel out of the UK to countries on the amber list shouldn't happen unless it is essential. And that's a message they've been trying to ram home. The legal ban on stopping people going on holiday was lifted yesterday, but the guidance now is pretty clear that people shouldn't be going to amber list countries. And that includes many in Europe, like France and Italy.
The latest daily coronavirus figures show another 7 people have died in the UK within 28 days of testing positive. More than 2,400 new cases were confirmed. Excavation work is to begin at a cafe in Gloucester tomorrow as police search for a suspected victim of the serial killer Fred West. Police have found 6 voids in the toilet area of the cafe where Mary Bastom, who was 15, worked before she went missing in 1968. Dorinda Ward knew Mary as a teenager.
If Mary is in the cafe, I hope for the family that it's closure for them. I mean, it's upset me. Because you always hope against hope that it's not going to end like that.
The supermodel Naomi Campbell has become a mother at the age of 50. She announced the news on Instagram, sharing a picture of her hand holding the baby girl's feet. In 2017, she spoke about wanting to have children and that with science she would be able to do it when she wanted. Football and the Crystal Palace manager Roy Hodgson is leaving after 4 years in charge. The 73-year-old said it was time to step away from the rigours of top-flight football. And that's the BBC News at 9:03. BBC Radio 2.
This is Jamie Cullum.
Jamie Cullum.
Jamie Cullum.
Jamie Cullum.
Jamie Cullum on BBC.
Radio 2.
Radio 2.
Good evening, this is Jamie Cullum. You're listening to BBC Radio 2, and I've got another hour of great jazz for you right now. This week, let me tell you what I've got coming up. You're going to hear a Take 5 interview with the drummer, Jazz Kayser. I've got new music from Joe Armand Jones, Emma Jean Thackeray, and Hiatus Coyote. So much great new stuff to get to. I'm going to go right back now to 1960. This is Ernestine Anderson and My Kind of Love.
Paradise.
That's My Kind of Love from Ernestine Amerson from the album My Kind of Swing that came out in 1960. She made many albums with a host of great people. Just on this album alone, Yusef Lateef, Clark Terry, Kenny Burrell. It's arranged by Ernie Wilkins. She made a lot of great records. Only passed away in 2016, aged 87. But I love that record, My Kind of Swing, if you haven't heard it before. That is a great track from it. Ernestine Amerson, My Kind of Love.